reality is that we are the champions of the universe, that we are constantly just beating whatever comes our way. Ah, Demonic Legion, we beat that. Ancient old void gods, we beat them. And now we are in the Shadowlands facing off some of the most primal forces ever, possibly the architects of the universe, and more than likely we will defeat them as well. However, you may have overlooked a few occasions where we actually lost, so let us take a look at 10 times we were defeated as players, whether those were complete and absolute defeats, pyrrhic victories, or really draws where there wasn't a clear victor and we just ended up worse than we were before. As we're talking about challenging battles, if you like the vibe of old, challenging RPG computer games, then Dragon Champions might just be the game for you. A classic right in your pocket. Dragon Champions takes some of the best RPG traditions and mixes them with a variety of game modes for all tastes, from lore-filled campaign mode to tower, arena, and various other modes. There is a wide range of races, as well as classes and professions that you can add to your collection, so you have anything from humans to goblins to elves and various others, and as any RPG, you can tank, DPS, and heal. Then you can mix and match them to create a raiding party, and you can do anything from sending them on expeditions to do the work while they're away, engaging in PvP, or just doing PvE, as the game presents quite a robust storyline. If you want to get a huge head start, check out my link in the description or just scan the QR code, and you can also support the channel as well. If you use the link, you get a special bonus, rewards worth $10, available once you reach level 5, as well as a completely free hero, Robin Vad, that you can see right on the screen. Check out Dragon Champions. Number 10, Garrosh. I would say this was a victory, but only a temporary one. However, in the end, we didn't really achieve much. Garrosh had become just way too power hungry, and he essentially became a full-on dictator on Azeroth, and even went as far as consuming the heart of a fallen old god, and overall just went too crazy. Well, both the Alliance and Horde Rebels united, sieged Orgrimmar, and ultimately put an end to the Warchief. Then, Terran Zhu called for a trial in Pandaria, and not the immediate punishment of Garrosh as Troll had suggested. Garrosh, however, couldn't be any less regretful of what he did during this trial, and ultimately, he even escaped his prison, opened an alternate universe portal, and created a brand new horde that he planned to invade Azeroth with, and pretty much just repeat what he could not with the main universe horde. We did stop it ultimately, but I definitely wouldn't call the Siege of Orgrimmar a complete victory, because while it did halt a villain temporarily, it ultimately created an even better opportunity for Garrosh, as well as gave us a brand new enemy to fight. Number 9, Deathwing. This one is a bit strange. Of course, we did ultimately manage to defeat the fallen dragon Aspect Neltharion, and later on even his master. However, how much of that was really a victory? I'd say at the end of Cataclysm, we did score a win, but at the start of the expansion, we just took one big L. Similar to how in Legion, we were defeated at the start, but later on put a stop to them. Seriously, Deathwing broke the link between the elemental and the material plane, and he caused the shattering, which was the biggest disaster to strike Azeroth since the Sundering over 10,000 years ago. I mean, Deathwing destroyed a significant part of Stormwind, he split the entire Barrens in half, he caused a massive whirl and twisted half of Strangleton Whale, and on top of that, completely reshaped like a dozen different zones. Now, despite this being good for us gameplay-wise, as they had updated much of Azeroth, let's be real here, from a civilian perspective, this was terrible, as I think it is pretty safe to say that many lost their homes and possessions during this cataclysmic catastrophe. Number 8, Alternate Draenor. So, while I'd say Warlords of Draenor was a defeat overall for World of Warcraft in general, lore-wise, Alternate Draenor was really just one big mess where we didn't exactly win. Looking at it from this perspective, it really was a filler expansion and just there to set up for the future Legion invasion. So Garrosh escaped, he ventured into the alternate timeline Draenor, set up there, and managed to create a tech-advanced Iron Horde. However, after that, we realized just how big the Legion influence was, and ultimately we had to take the fight to them. While we were successful at the time and we went into the Hellfire Citadel and defeated many of their minions, it really just seemed like one big elaborate trap just so that they can kickstart a new Legion invasion, which did happen shortly after. I'd say we thwarted them at least a bit. Instead of them going through the main portal immediately, they had to kinda go through the back door, but regardless, the invasion still occurred, so the victory was a minor setback for them at best. We did manage to defeat Archimonde, but it didn't really mean all that much, as he kinda just sent Gul'dan through the portal to just set the ground at the Broken Isles. Number 7, Ashara. So, in Battle for Azeroth, we went through this elaborate plan of stopping the summoning of N'Zoth as he was super close to breaking free, as well as fighting Queen Ashara. With the help of Magni, we empowered the Heart of Azeroth and we fought our way through Najatar. Ultimately, we ended up in the Eternal Palace and we faced off against Ashara in direct combat. However, little did we know that she was actually just pulling us into this elaborate trap, as she actually wanted the Heart of Azeroth and she siphoned the power in order to shatter the prison and ultimately free N'Zoth after having been put behind bars countless eons ago by the Titans. So, pretty much, we just brought the energy source directly to her doorstep. She didn't have to go out of her way to find it. We did later on defeat N'Zoth, although even that victory is not really clear. However, we never really managed to beat Ashara, as later on we ran into her and she escaped as well, and later revealed to us that the reason she could free N'Zoth was so that she could get him herself. So ultimately, this really was an unclear situation, but it is undeniable that we were toyed around with and ultimately just served as pawns in Queen Ashara's plans. Number 6, Vrat Gate. The most iconic event in WoW ever, really, and I'd say possibly the first ever major loss that really hit us. So, just as we had established ourselves in Northrend and got the ball rolling, the Horde and the Alliance combined a significant number of their forces and launched a direct assault on the main gate of the Iceground Citadel, challenging the Lich King directly. Well, Arthas came out, killed Saurfang in an instant, but overall, we had quite a good chance as we wiped out pretty much everything else Arthas threw at us, at least by that point. Well, lo and behold, the Grand Apothecary shows up, throws a bunch of plague battles our way, and completely obliterates both the Alliance and the Horde, and significantly delays our offensive against the Lich King. I don't really think people overall realize just how significant this loss was for the story overall. Because of this plague attack and the dragons, Bolvar was created as a future Lich King, and his storyline that is relevant up to this day, the trust in the Forsaken was significantly broken, and ultimately, a split here happened between the Horde and the Alliance that will forever sour the relationship, shaping all future events. Number 5, Battle for Azeroth. This one is really hard to define, as certain parties won, certain parties lost, but overall, really it was one big loss for both factions. Technically, the Alliance did ultimately win this war and the Horde did lose, but this was a pyrrhic victory at best. First of all, Teldrassil was completely burnt down, with countless numbers of Night Elves perishing, as well as anything relevant to Night Elven culture. Then, during the battle for Lordaeron, which was retaliation, the entirety of Undercity was plagued and made completely uninhabitable, with most of Tirisfal Glades being burnt to a crisp. To top it all off, countless other zones were damaged, navies and armies lost. All of this is of course natural in a war, but the battle for Azeroth was unlike anything else, because both factions lost a major city and a race capital, and really, despite the war reaching a ceasefire, the damage will take a really long time to repair. So it is hard to say that this was a black and white loss, but let's be real here, many denizens of Azeroth would call this war a loss. Number 4, Sargeras. So, while, yes, we did win against the Burning Legion and we had imprisoned Sargeras, it was both a victory and a defeat. Sure, it was a large victory as the Legion was at least temporarily put to a halt and significantly weakened, but it was also a major loss at the same time. Not only did we lose a lot of our forces in these campaigns, but ultimately, just before we could imprison the Dark Titan, he pulled out his planet-sized sword and stabbed Azeroth nearly to the core. In the cinematic, the stabbing looked bad because it actually was, and Azeroth only survived by a single thread. Sargeras literally impaled the sword like halfway through the planet, and worst of all, there was significant poison within the blade that took a ton of effort as well as all of the artifacts we had previously gathered in order to purify the wound. So, while we did win, we still got that gigantic sword in Silithus that isn't exactly a sign of victory, and even cleansed, I'm guessing it could be used as a weapon in the future. Number 3, Sanctum of Domination. The most recent fight that we still don't really know the consequences of, however, what is 100% certain is that really we lost in this encounter. We ventured into the most inner chamber of the jailer, right in the middle of them all, and fought his most loyal and powerful minions, yet all of it was really a trap as Zowal's ultimate goal was to reach Oribos and take the sigil from the Arbiter in order to return to his primal form. Now that we're aware that he was the original Arbiter of the Shadowlands, he was completely successful in his mission as he reunited with his sigil and empowered himself. Now, while we did fight and win against pretty much every challenge thrown our way, ultimately, here we were defeated and the jailer's goals were furthered. As a consoling prize, we did manage to get Sylvanas to break away from her master, but once again, we don't really know what consequences of that will be in the future. Number 2, Lich King. This might actually be the true and the only time we were just completely defeated, like an absolute defeat. In fact, Artis may have been the smartest villain out of all of them. He realized that we win all the time, that we're unstoppable, so after we cut through all of his scourge challenges, he lured us to attack him directly at the Ice Crown Citadel. Then he froze Tyrion immediately, immobilizing him, toyed around with us, and defeated the entire party in a single blow. Then his plan came to fruition as he started resurrecting us players, his greatest new asset and the most powerful future weapons. However, the Lich King underestimated the Light in Tyrion, and the Paladin broke from the ice block, shattered Frostmourne, and we were resurrected by the spirit of Terranus. While our defeat lasted a bit less than a minute, it was really the first time we were completely defeated by a boss. We weren't stunned, wounded, dazed, or whatever. Artis quite literally killed us. And lastly, number 1, Broken Shore. The defeat, and I'd say one of the worst disasters for both the Alliance and the Horde. So, as the Legion was making headway into Azeroth in the biggest assault since the Sundering, the factions prepared to defend the planet. However, the scouts realized that there was no way we could do a frontal assault and that it wouldn't be possible and it would literally be just straight suicide or just walking into it, yet the Dreadlords played their tricks and the invasion still happened. First, the Argent Crusade was completely destroyed with Tyrion being captured and ultimately dying. Then, Warchief Vol'jin was struck down, which called for an immediate retreat, but everyone was getting overwhelmed anyway, so there really was no hope. Some managed to escape, but a gigantic fell golem held onto one of the airships, which caused Varian to jump down and ultimately sacrifice himself. The end result? We didn't stop anything, the Legion invasion continued, and both the Alliance and the Horde lost their leaders, and this further caused tensions between the factions to escalate. Overall, this was single-handedly the worst loss that ever happened to us, both for the players and the factions. Thank you for watching! Check out what were the top 10 good things Geralt did by clicking on the screen, and also check out Doron's Academy for videos on real-world history and science. See you next time!